Good afternoon, Mr. President. When do you plan to appoint a permanent secretary in the Department of Health? And also, will the government order any restrictions to the movement of people, especially now that there are more sub-variants of COVID-19 that have been detected? And experts are saying COVID cases could increase in the next weeks or months.
Yes. What we have to understand about COVID and the way that we are treating it is that the risk factor of getting COVID in 2022 is very, very different from the risk factor of getting COVID in 2020 or 2021. And that is indicated by the hospitalizations and the rate of the death. And meron talaga, nung nagsimula ang pandemya, meron tayong mga naririnig na kaso, meron tayong alam, tayo, sarili, personal, na mga wala namang sakit, wala namang, hindi naman dapat sasabihin na may comorbidity, ay hindi pa rin nakakapag-survive. Ngayon, masasabi natin, maliwanag, it is those patients with comorbidities that have been our fatalities. So we cannot look at it the same way. And that is why we still have, it is the same situation that I have in the Department of Agriculture. We have to get away from the emergency stance of the DOH, because we have to open up businesses. We have to make the Philippines more hospitable to travelers, both business and tourists. And it does not help if we are still under a state of calamity, if we are the only country that still has a mask protocol. But these are mandated to us by the laws that were passed during the pandemic. So kailangan pa nating ayusin yun. And until that's fixed, and once again, until those changes, in the case of the DOH, it's not structural changes, but in the case of DOH, it's the method of handling the pandemic. We must treat the pandemic no longer, we must treat COVID no longer as an emergency, but something that we will have to manage forever. It's like flu, like pneumonia. Nandyan lagi yan, pero mag-ingat tayo para hindi tayo magkasakit. And that is the way that we should be handling COVID. We cannot remove ourselves yet from the way that we are handling it. Dahil, halimbawa, pag tinanggal ko yung state of calamity, hindi makukuha ng ating mga health workers yung kanilang benepisyo na nasa batas. Hindi tayo makakapag-import ng vaccine, yung sa procurement, masyadong mabagal ang magiging procurement. Yung indemnification fund na linagay diyan para pagka nagka-problema sa mga paggamit ng vaccine, ay meron tayong pambayad. All of this will disappear pag tinanggal yung state of calamity. Pero ngayon, sinasabi ko, naghahanap kami ng paraan para nga manormalize na natin. At hindi na natin kailangan sabihin na ang Pilipinas state of calamity pa rin. Para masabi natin sa ating mga potential investors, pumunta kayo rito sa Pilipinas, maayos na. Pwede natin sabihin sa ating mga kaibigan na mga dayuhan, bumisita kayo rito at maganda na ang Pilipinas, hindi nyo na kailangan ialala ang COVID-19. Kaya yun ang hanggat paabutin natin doon. And then we will normalize also all the reorganization of the government.
How about the DOH secretary? When do you plan to appoint a permanent secretary?
Of?
The DOH, since OIC pa lang po meron.
When that happens, when what I just explained happens, the same as DA. Maayos na, normalize na. The reason when all of these things happen, kuminsan you do not hear from me. And hindi, sinasabi ko yung mga secretary sila ang mag-statement. The reason is, I want people to understand that this is the government's work. Not everything is a crisis. So, inormalize natin ang trabaho ng gobyerno. That is what I am trying to do. So that everyday functions are fulfilled every day. Without fuss, without bother, without gulo, without fixers, without paying. Yan ang inaayos ko. So that is what I'm hoping to get to that point, especially in the DOH and the Department of Agriculture.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Malacanang Press Corps.
Thank you very much.